My last few videos have been kind of lighthearted. This is not. I got this book in 2021 and I am not even halfway through it. And every time I pick it back up, I remember why it has taken me so long to pick back up. This book is about women's history and it starts all the way back in hunter-gatherer times, which that's a whole nother thing. It's very interesting. From there, it goes to when the population of the world began to expand even more, and the world was in matriarchy. There was only female leaders, and there was only female gods and deities. The earliest known religion was a female god. Goddess, if you will. So basically, this matriarchal world where women were leaders, women were literally worshipped as goddesses walking on earth. It makes me very emotional. So that all fell when collectively we started to piece together how babies were made. That discovery that pregnancy and birth was not something magical that women just did, it was something that could be done to women. Then came the rise of patriarchy. Then came the rise of father gods. And now we are here to the fall of woman, which is this chapter. And this is an excerpt about child brides, all right? And she says here that this was recorded as late as 1921, which was over 100 years ago, but child brides are not a thing of the past. That still happens today. This is a massive trigger warning. I wish I hadn't read this, and I'm only reading it again because I feel like it's important. As late as 1921, the British government official census of India recorded that 3,200,000 child brides had died during the previous 12 months under circumstances recorded by British Army doctors. Quote, A, aged 9, day after marriage. Left femur dislocated, pelvis crushed out of shape, flesh hanging in shreds. B, age 10, unable to stand, bleeding profusely, flesh much lacerated. C, age 9, so completely ravished as to be almost beyond surgical repair. Her husband had 2 other living wives and spoke very fine English. I, age 7, living with husband, died in great agony after 3 days. M, age 10, crawled to hospital on her hands and knees, has never been able to stand erect since her marriage. Also, later in that chapter, she talks about how a lot of the child brides were also FGM victims, and that the husband would wear the blade, or sometimes just the really sharp rock he would use to cut her open before raping her, would wear it bloodied around town, like as a trophy. It absolutely fills me with rage when I read things like that and I hear about things like that, and I am once again just faced with the knowledge of the reality that the torture that women and girls have faced at the hands of men, and men have the fucking audacity to cry misandry and to really say things like misandry is just as bad as misogyny. Show me anywhere in the world ever recorded in history where it was not only acceptable but like a traditional practice for grown women to marry little boys and rape them until their bones were crushed and they were unable to stand. When men hate women, that's how they hate us. Women will never want to express their hatred that same way. Women will never desire revenge in that same way. Women will never hate men the way that they hate us. And you know what? This makes me think of that Andrea Dworkin quote. She said something along the lines of, have you ever wondered why women are not just in armed combat against men? It's not because there's a shortage of kitchen knives. It's because we believe in humanity. We believe in your humanity despite all the evidence.